Hey, what's up everybody, my name is TrophyNet and welcome back to our Commander playthrough of XCOM 2. As you can see, I've had a bit of a change of heart and I've replaced Geralt with Ulrich Edel, who's back from the infirmary, back from being wounded. He is, however, if you check out the list here, he is shaken from his wounds. So we're gonna have to look out for that, but he can recover greatly if we're successful in this mission. He's still only a corporal, so he needs a bit of leveling up as well. I'm gonna keep the rest, because we kind of need this on this moderate mission. So, Terelia is still our sniper. Then we have Humongous as our healer. Christoph Vinewood, our runner, our ranger, is gonna be really helpful in this mission. And then, of course, our main specialist, Benito Buffon, the technician. So, here we go. So I had that change of heart as well. I want to incorporate more of your characters instead of the more generic ones that I created that are just linked to popular franchises. So let's begin the mission, Operation Dying Gears.
We're picking up a steady stream of communications coming from a hidden alien comm relay uploading data to the Advent network from this region. We have to take advantage of every opportunity to disrupt the aliens' progress on their latest operation. So we're moving in to destroy the relay before they complete the transfer. Don't leave any hostiles standing.
So this is good. It's destroying an alien transmitter relay, which shouldn't be too hard just to get there in the turns that we get. Because if we fail this mission, just wanna emphasize this, if we fail this mission, we fail to block the UFO. And we don't want to have that. So that's also the reason why Ulrich, our grenadier, will be so important this mission. Might have actually taken two, that should have been a better idea, but never mind. Because he will be able to blast us a path through everything to reach that thing. Holy, that is far away. So everybody is concealed, I think. Yeah, squad got concealment. So let's not waste any time and let's move up. Let's move everybody up as far as we can. Let's see. We don't need to take cover just yet, because we have concealment. Let's put Humongous over there, and Christoph. You know what, Christoph? Let's move you up a bit further. So it's across the street. So, yeah. The further we can get in the shortest amount of time, the better. He doesn't see anybody yet. There seems to be... Oh, that's that tower. Nothing in particular. Let's move Benito over. Ulrich as well. And just keep everybody closely grouped together. Maybe behind a bench here. There we go. Just 8 turns is not a lot. Well, I say 8 turns, but now we only have 7 left, of course. Cedric. Where do we put you? You know what, you need to get closer anyway. Could put you on top of this building, actually. What is the access point over there using that pipe? Might not actually be that bad of an idea. Just put you here. We can't see to the side of that building, so there shouldn't be any aliens that spot you over there, except if there's anything in that building. Okay.
Extremely well-equipped mechanized combat unit. We'll need to look for vulnerabilities if we're going to take that thing out.
So luckily we have our combat hacker available if the need arises. So Benito can hack that mech, which would be really, really handy. But we're not there yet. I don't want to get spotted by anyone here. So let's just move up slowly. Well, I say slowly, but just going to move up as far as I can. But not sprinting just yet. So just we can... move up where we need to.
Okay.
So Ulrich is shaken, but that might be helped when we are successful in this mission. Ulrich, put yourself... You know what? Let's put you over there. Christoph over here. Benito. I want to start thinking about cover. Let's put you over. Oh, I think he saw something. Unless I'm just out of turns, that could be. Yeah. Okay. Ooh. A Viper, a Lancer, and a Trooper, that was, right? That's a Viper, yeah, a Trooper, and there's the... Okay, so I could blow open the wall if needs be. We're about in range, which is okay, I guess. So let's put everybody... Humongous, I needed you to be behind cover as well. And there we go, so now they can move around a bit. Okay, we're gonna have to plan this really, really tightly, because we have 5 enemies on the map right now. Which is bad. I'm not gonna lie, that is bad. Benito, where are you? There we go. Let's start by checking out this tower. Because that doesn't take a turn as long as I don't decide anything. If it's anything good, we might actually take advantage of that. So, disorient enemies for 2 turns, or a soldier gains complete immunity from the next 2 attacks. And the feedback is only an alarm, so failed hack will result in any nearby enemy groups being alerted to your position. We're not gonna do that just yet, because immunity is nice, but, well, it's only 25%, and disorientation could be handy as well, but we're not gonna do that yet. Next up, let's check out our chances of hacking that mech. So let's go with Haywire Protocol. I don't think that... No. Because I think we get... Yeah, we'll reveal squad. But it's this. For some reason, Haywire Protocol does not reveal the squad. So let's check the mech out. There we go. What are our chances? So 60% for a disable and only 30% for a control. So that's bad. That's really, really bad. So we're not going to do that just yet either. So let's set this up a bit better. Move Benito over here. That shouldn't trigger anything. I hope. Yeah, okay. Because we have had bugs with that in the past. Oh, wait. Those guys have disappeared for some reason, so I might actually just open fire on the guys that we're seeing right now. But let's see. Hugh, let's put you in a better position over here behind full cover. Nothing bad going on. Then Vryer. I do want to have full cover for you as well, so let's put you over here. Does that give you sight on any of the... No, okay, so there's nobody up there. So that means we're not going to trigger them if we start shooting, which is good. We only have 2 enemies in sight. That's actually interesting. I wonder if... Ulrich, do you have... Shredder, yeah, you have Shredder, so that's actually pretty good as well. So 73 on the mech, and it can remove some of its armor. But let's try and first get a shot off on the Lancer. If that's a headshot, which is a 40% chance, we actually take him out, and we only need to deal with the mech. And then we can use the mech, maybe, to try something else. But here we go. Oh, 6 damage. Okay, that's not too bad. So, well, what is he going to do? Are they coming to come closer, or are they going to pull back? So, mech and Lancer. Here we go. Okay, that's not bad, actually. Does Ulrich still have a shot on the mech? He does. Ooh, more important question. Oh no, I can't hack the mech anymore. Well, that's too bad. Don't want to blow up the truck either, because Benito is close to it. And I don't think the radius of the explosion will reach the mech, so that's not in our favor. So let's try this first then. 71% on the mech, and it should take out 1 bit of armor as well. Here we go. Ooh, that's nice. One armor taken, 4 damage taken as well. So that means we still have 4 damage we need to do. I don't think the truck is smoking from that either. So we can take out the Lancer with a controlled shock. That was of Five Nights at Freddy's. Oh yeah, and he's still in concealment as well. A Five Nights at Freddy's reference, sorry. Should learn to finish my sentences. Humongous only has a shot on the Lancer as well. Which makes this a bit tough. Because if I move up, I think I might trigger the other guys again. Let's try and take out the Lancer with Humongous. With their fancy new weapons, by the way, so that's 6 damage. Okay, enemy neutralized. Then we have... I could throw a grenade over the truck, right on top of the mech here. So if I have... And I don't think I have sight with anybody else. If I move you over... If I move you over here, what happens? I'm gonna get sight of the mech, but I want to see... Oh yeah, okay, so now he sees everybody else as well. So we can't take a shot with him. This is annoying. So the only two guys I have left is Christophe, who's in concealment still. But if I shoot with him, he's gonna trigger those guys. I don't want to have that happen just yet. So I think this is gonna be a round of Overwatches for now. Could use a grenade, but it won't kill the mech either, so better to have an Overwatch shot with his magnetic rifle than anything else. So let's put them on Overwatch. Hopefully that doesn't cost Ulrich's life. So he's moving. That's really good, because now Benito has a shot. Oh, and he misses. Oh shit, that's bad. Because now the mech has a flank shot on Benito. Oh, and he misses! He misses! How does he miss that? That was... How the hell did he miss that? Never mind. Let's see. I have 5 turns left, so that's plenty of time to get there. Because I don't want to trigger those guys up there. So... I think, Vrijer, can you do the same thing you did before? So 73 damage, 73% to get at least 4 damage, because it's gonna shred the rest of the armor as well if it hits. Ooh, straight in the belly of the mech. Oh, I could have tried to take it over now, because Benito is right in front of it. Never mind. Are we gonna take out the guys up there immediately? I should, shouldn't I? It's 3 guys though, so I don't want to risk it just yet. Do have to be careful with my troop movement a bit. But I think I can put a few guys closer without triggering any of the guys on top. Oh, I did. I just did. Never mind. Let's scratch that. Okay. Not that big of an issue, I think. Because, most importantly, we have a sniper shot. Ooh, those are bad shots. Okay, but we still have the shotgunner as well. So that is probably a kill on one of those. But how far does Benito's grenade reach? I can just get inside of the building. Is he located? Where is he located? Yeah, okay, so that's square over there, so that should actually hit the stun lancer inside, which is good, because I can't throw the grenade higher up to get to the Viper. So yeah, I'm gonna take it on the stun lancer downstairs. Boom! Here we go. That doesn't drop down the Viper, sadly. But that opens up a shot for Cedric. So now he has a 100% shot on the stun lancer. So he's dead. He is completely dead. Who else do we have? We have Smongo, who has a shot on the Viper and the Trooper. But we can't move him anymore. So that's dangerous. I could actually try and hack the pillar over here. That should That should disorient both of them. If I have the chance, because now... So yeah, the sniper shot is gonna be on the stun lancer. No, we're gonna do that immediately just so we can see what's left on the board. There we go, goodbye! And now...
Not too shabby.
So the Viper has 8 health. So we're gonna need at least 2 shots to get that thing down. The Viper now also has only half cover, so but that's still 55%. I should try it though. 50-50 is always good. Well, not always good. It's a chance. So Hugh, please. Oh, that's a hit. 7 damage. Ooh, that's great. That might actually mean I have a shot at this. Literally, that is. Because if I put Christophe to the side of the truck over here...
Closing on target position now.
I might actually... 60%, that's not great. That's not great at all. 60% and 46, so that's not great at all. And I do have to be careful now. And with careful, I mean I'm really tempted to use the sword just to take out the trooper over there. Which is 94%, so could still miss. Which would be dramatic for Christophe, so I'm not gonna risk it. I'm just gonna put him on Overwatch and see what happens, because the trooper... but I do have to take out that trooper. I'm gonna have to take out the trooper, because he can flank us easily if he wants to. So yeah, Blade Storm it is, well, Slash it is, and take out the trooper, please, and hopefully don't trigger anything else, because otherwise I'm gonna be fucked. Oh, trooper down. Doesn't trigger anything else. This is gonna hurt. Don't trigger.
Not too shabby.
Oh, God, okay. So now the Viper is alone with 1 health left. What is he going to do? Okay, yeah, okay. Whew. He is retreating. Okay. That means I have Christophe available to try and check out where the Viper went. Because if I can see where he went... He can be killed. Because Christophe has the Shadow Step ability, which doesn't trigger Overwatch. So even if the Viper went on Overwatch, I should be able to evade that. So let's take a look inside of the building. That is not looking inside of the building, but never mind. And now let's check. I could check up, but I don't want to just yet. So let's just check the corner of the building. And I don't see a Viper. That is worse. But not dramatic. But let's move everybody up a bit so they can start having sight lines. Swap everybody out. And put everybody on Overwatch. We're pretty close to the data transfer thingy. So that shouldn't be too bad. And I still have Cedric on Overwatch right now. So if the Viper moves, he's gonna die. So everybody on Overwatch. Take that Viper out.
The alien transmission is still active and we're running out of time. Get to the relay and take it out, ASAP.
Where is he? Oh, for fuck's sake. The Viper is not showing itself. Which either means he's...
I can handle that.
He's probably hiding up here somewhere. Still not visible. Okay, then I'm gonna have to be careful about this though. So we have 3 turns left. That thing only has 6 health, so with our upgraded weaponry that won't be a problem. But I do have to be careful to not trigger anything else. So let's move everybody close together. And keep Cedric over here on Overwatch. Yeah. What am I gonna do about that? That Viper is a real bitch. Ulrich, how far does your grenade reach? Can you blow open the wall? You can actually, and even get it inside. So yeah, why not, eh? No, I'm gonna wait. Let's put everybody on Overwatch. We know we can do that now. So let's just wait. So the Viper is clearly on the other side of the building. But if it shows up, it's dead again. Okay. This is starting to get really weird. The Viper just fucked off. Let's put Ulrich over here. Doesn't seem like he's triggering anything. So let's blast this entire building to Kingdom Kong. There we go. That should blow it right open and give our other characters a chance, or other soldiers. Yeah, 4 damage. Thank you, game. That was a bit premature, but thank you, game. So that's that. And now... Yeah, indeed. You can see it. So Benito has a shot, but I do want to be careful here. Let's put Smongo on the side of the building. See what happens. I can't move everybody around still, so he doesn't... Yeah, 5-7 damage. Finish this thing off. So there we go. Now we have all the time in the world to take out the rest of the aliens. Which should be another batch, I think.
We confirmed destruction of the relay. The alien transmission is down. Eliminate any remaining hostiles and move to evac.
I think I'm going to just put everybody on Overwatch, except for Cedric, who I'm going to move up a bit. Just in case we're going to need him on the other building up there. So move him up and then reload his sniper rifle. And that's the last thing, apparently. The Viper still doesn't like to show his face, apparently, which is really, really troubling. So what I want to do is slowly move everybody through the building and put, eventually put most of them on the roof as well. So let's see, how far on the roof can we get with Humongous? Let's put Humongous on the ground level and let him make it through the building. Is that through the fire? It looks like there's fire over there, but I'm gonna take the safe route over here. There we go. And reload you as well, because you need some ammunition as well. Let's put Christophe on Overwatch, because we don't have a timer anymore. Benito on Overwatch, and then Briar to this corner. And reload his machine gun as well. So that should have been everybody except for Cedric, probably. Yeah, okay. So let's just boost him up towards the building. A nice action shot of him moving to the side of the building. And now... Oh, there's movement. Oh, what the hell is that? That is a nice bunch of aliens. So we have a trooper, a mech, and a sectoid, and somebody triggered Overwatch. Oh, that's the mech. The Viper still isn't dead. Benito missed a shot. So we got 4 damage on the mech, if I'm not mistaken, and the Viper is still alive. So, what can we see the Viper from here? Yeah, okay. So we could use... Lightning hands to take a shot at the Viper. Could we get any closer? Ooh, he's actually positioned himself pretty nicely. The mech is really close to Christophe, but with his damage output, that should be an immediate kill if we need to. So let's see. Vryar still has a grenade as well. What can that grenade do? We could take out both the trooper and the Viper, which is actually really nice. The sectoid, I could actually try this as well. So that should open up the sectoid as well. Well, why not, eh? Ulrich, here we go. That should make this mission really successful for you, because you killed the Viper. And opened up the sectoid. There we go. Benito, how far can you get? If I put you over here to the side. Nobody went on Overwatch because the Viper was the only one that had turns available. So there we go. Ooh, I actually have a flank shot on the sectoid as well. What's your shot on the trooper? No. Okay. That's nice. And let's put Terilia right next to you, and let's see what your shots are. There we go.
I can handle that.
With your mag pistol, because that has been upgraded as well. So, actually has better shots on the trooper. So, let's try and take out the trooper with your lightning hands first. Oh, 3 damage to the face. Okay. So let's try then first Benito's shot at the sectoid. Might just kill it outright. 78%. Ooh, this is working out great. And then we actually have a grenade as well. But Smongo has a shot as well, and I think Smongo actually... Yeah, why not, eh? Let's put Smongo in the perfect position to blast this trooper to the next, the next life. 94%. In the face, brain splattered all over the ground. Goop coming out of every orifice. That might have been a bit too graphic. And now we have, this mech here. Could actually go with a really, really ridiculous shot and just stand at his ass. Because we have 97% and I feel I want to have 100. There we go, guaranteed kill. Goodbye. And I think there was a sound of, loot. You know, loot dropped good. And he's going to get it immediately because he was so close. Confirmed.
All hostiles are down and the area is secure.
Oh yeah.
Status confirmed. Mission accomplished.
So Operation Dying Gears completed flawlessly. So that should lift Ulrich's spirits right back. So he made most attacks. Humongous dealt most damage apparently. Wow, as healer, that's really impressive. Benito again most under fire in case of the runner, of course, moved the furthest. And a 100% successful shot percentage. We're getting really, really good at this. So luckily we upgraded our weapons because that would have been a lot tougher otherwise. But nice work, guys. Nice work indeed. What are the promotions? No promotions.
Looks to me like it's working out just fine.
That's saddening, but to be expected probably, because most of these guys are very high level. And I think Ulrich got a promotion in the previous mission. So, an advanced expanded magazine. So clip size is increased by 2 and another data pad. 2 stun lancer corpses, 2 mech racks, 2 trooper corpses, a viper and a sectoid. So advent mech breakdown. These mechanized units have a familiar humanoid form, but we haven't found any indication of a pilot or biological control system. I'm hoping that once we've pulled it apart, I'll be able to mirror some of their advancements in our own weapons and robotic systems.
You have done an outstanding job leading the resistance, Commander.
Thank you. So there we go, soldier recovered, Ulrich Edel will restored and increased. That was what we were aiming at, so that's really, really nice. Let's see. I'm gonna head immediately to the bridge because I don't think we have anything open for the rest. Amusement center. Huh. Reduce contact cost.
Avenger,
that is interesting.
I
pressed investigate without actually checking everything else. Which might be bad. Because reduce contact cost isn't actually that good. Supplies is actually better. We have not finished scanning at this location. Of course we want to leave because supplies are always handy. There we go. So let's keep checking this. Ooh, supplies. 57 supplies. Beneath the looming statue of an elder, we noticed an overgrown security checkpoint. Placed at the intersection of 2 roads. After further inspection, the corpse of an advanced security officer was discovered, slumped over the small desk inside. Our engineers swept aside and recovered a number of useful system components. Okay, thank you very much. What else can we do? We could heal faster, not that we need that right now. We still have an advent black site we could hit, but we're not gonna do that, so... Yeah, not much on the map right now, so let's go to... Yeah, you know what? Resistance HQ, and let's check that out. There we go. Let's check the bonuses out. Gather intelligence or rapid construction. I could use rapid construction, actually. Don't really need any of the other guys because they're really pricey as well. So let's just swap to rapid construction. And let's do that.
Welcome, Commander.
Nope. Build faster. There we go. Proving grounds constructed.
Build the Skulljack whenever you give the word.
Ooh, that is very, very interesting. So let's view the facility. Because the proving grounds is one of those really, really interesting rooms. As we can make some really nice stuff in this thing. Not only the the Skulljack, as Shen just mentioned. So let's put Maria Kuznetsova in there to reduce the project time. You know what? I'm actually doubting how fast. So 7 days for the Skulljack. We're gonna do that immediately, the Skulljack. And maybe after that, I'm gonna remove her.
I'll let you know as soon as we've made progress.
So now we have 7 days until one. We can actually make multiple Skulljacks because that's an item that we can equip one of our specialists with. But we're gonna make do with just one right now. So one Skulljack, 7 days. And that's 7 days, otherwise would be 14 days if we didn't have the engineer there. So let's check the rest out. So 6 days for clearing alien machinery, which isn't that bad. And then we can construct something over there as well. There we go, back to the bridge. And let's continue building faster. I think that's gonna go into clearing that out as well. Oh, and that's worse. So the Avatar project gains a bit more progress as well.
Commander,
there we go.
Continue to make progress on the Avatar project.
One block, that's not too bad. We still have five left. So I am actually wondering, does that speed up the clearing? It doesn't seem like it does that. Which is sad, because I don't think I can change that again. No. So, reduce contact cost. Would that be a general reduction in contact cost? That's actually interesting. Wondering if that is the case. Huh. Let's scan here anyway. Okay, and that is a bit worse. So resistant havens under assault. Another retaliation mission. Okay. Advent is attacking one of the resistance havens in the New Arctic again. Because I think it's actually the same resistance haven.
Setting course.
So let's go there, so we know what retaliation missions are all about. They're all about... where are you going? Shouldn't you need to go to that thing? Yeah, okay. So they're all about saving civilians. Which means we're gonna need... Grenadiers would be nice, but sniper rifles are just as helpful in that scenario. Healing is less of a... less of an issue there, so we might actually remove Humongous for a minute and go with a double Grenadiers. Not gonna take any rookies. Rookies would be really bad in a mission like this, because it's moderate. Is that what we need, what we want to do? So Christoph can be our scout again. Benito has the ability to check if any civilians are faceless, so we can deal with them first and try to save the civilians instead of the faceless. And then one really good sniper, able to take an overwatch view of everything else. And then of course the two grenadiers who can lay waste to anything in sight. Might actually swap out the flashbang from Christoph and swap that out for something else. Let's give him a grenade and give the flashbang to Geralt again, because they can shoot them farther, and I think the range is actually bigger as well. The radius, the blast radius of the grenades will be bigger as well. Is that it? We got that advanced magazine, which could be really, really handy. On who would that be really handy? I think on the... Oh, that was not what I wanted to do. I think I should put that on... You know what? I should put that on someone who doesn't have an upgrade already, because I think... The sniper rifle is already equipped with a scope, but the new weapons actually can be equipped with a second mod, if I'm not mistaken. There we go. So the shotgun now has, I think, if I'm not mistaken, 4 shots, which is actually pretty good. Should I give that? You know what? I'm gonna give that to Vryer's machine gun, because he has the shredder ability. Here we go, and I don't think he has any... Yeah, okay, there we go. Advanced autoloader would be nice, but let's put the advanced expanded magazine on top of that. And that should give him 5 shots instead of 3, which is really good. So, that's the squad we're going to head into with. Let's go. That So this is the squad we're going to use in the next retaliation mission. But that will have to wait until the next episode, because I'm going to take a little break. So thank you guys enormously for watching. If you enjoyed the episode, don't forget to like it right here on YouTube. And if you haven't already, don't forget to give it a thought to subscribe to my channel, because I really appreciate any support you guys can give me. So thanks again enormously for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video or series. Goodbye!